Rihanna, how was the meal?
It was so good. I've eaten my body weight in lamb and cow.
Hey guys, so when you think of Abu Dhabi, Formula One races, and iconic landmarks like the Louvre might pop into your mind, along with the glitz and the glam showcased in blockbuster films like the Too Fast, Too Furious franchise and Sex and the City. But honestly, that's just a small part of Abu Dhabi. Welcome to my Hidden Gem series, a series that uncovers and discovers the hidden gems in Abu Dhabi. And over the next few episodes, I will be delving into the city's culinary scene, sharing the lesser-known treasures that pack a punch with flavor.
That's the nicest thing I've ever tasted.
Without breaking the bank. So first up on our journey is an Afghani bakery, which is nestled in downtown Abu Dhabi. And true to the title of the video, Hidden Gems, this bakery is quite literally a hole in the wall. They serve bolani, which is a stuffed Afghani bread, and it's baked right in front of you.
With mozzarella. I think this one. Mozzarella, yeah.
After choosing which bolani we wanted, I was quite concerned with the man chopping his fingernails and toenails on the street. The only consolation is that I could see the chef, and it wasn't him.
Can I light your cigarette while you're waiting? But it's just attached to the case.
I had no idea that was a thing. Doesn't seem very safe.
While we were waiting for our bolani, we went next door to an Indian restaurant and saw a man eating a massive, literal bucket of food. But the food is really good, so I don't blame him. One thing I will say about Abu Dhabi is never judge a restaurant or you eat by how it looks. Most of the places don't look great, but the food is so good, and actually, touch wood, I've never got sick from anything I've eaten.
Okay, so we've got the goods. So now it's time for the taste test. Oh my god, it smells so good. Mm. Oh my god. I don't even know which one this one is, but it's amazing. The bread.
Show it is.
Okay. Here it is. Okay, so this is it over here. It's kind of like a Lebanese manouchi. You can see this must be a cheese and potato one. Manouchi, manakesh, I think is all the different ways. But yeah. It's so good. You can see the mozzarella cheese spilling out. You're right, green chilies would be a really nice addition to it.
So you can see the size. I'm just gonna call it a manouchi for easiness. But this over here is 5 dirhams.
That is less than $1.50. And it's absolutely delicious.
So next up on our list of places to visit is Najd Palace. This is a Saudi restaurant actually, but obviously we are super lucky in Abu Dhabi as the Arabic food scene is amazing. It's also a great place to go for a super authentic experience. You have to take off your shoes and sit in these little booths with your friends and family.
Oh, cute!
And you've got in this belt, your coffee.
Blue with a view. So cute.
There's my little tableware. You know the food's good when the menu looks like this.
Whoa. Cheers, everyone! It's like so hot. I'm gonna burn my mouth, I'm sure.
We got 3 different rice dishes, which I was very excited to try, but it was also my first time trying camel, so I was a little bit apprehensive and nervous.
Okay, so Sama, what do we have here?
This is mandi.
Mandi.
Which is just like, it's been cooked underground for like, I don't know, 8 hours or something, probably overnight. And that's lamb. This is the same thing but with camel and different type of rice.
Camel
meat. And that one again is lamb, but you can see it's cooked a little bit differently. Yeah. So a bit more like charred, I guess, and then it comes with potato. As well. That one's called medfoon.
It's called what?
Medfoon.
Our friend Osama showed us how you eat this type of food, and then after learning from him, I decided to take the leap and to try the camel.
About this, but I said I would try.
It's really good.
What does it taste like?
Like lamb. Yeah. Maybe that strong. The lamb.
I just can't get the portion that I'm eating in camp.
So one massive tray of rice and meat cost around 70 dirhams or $20. We got three different meats to try, but we definitely could have shared just one.
Oh yeah, how was the meal?
It was so good. I've eaten my body weight in lamb and cow. and when the hair goes up when you don't see it. Because it's like, you don't want food to go into it.
After that meal, we decided to check out a famous Kanafa restaurant. But first, we decided to walk off our food a bit and have some insightful conversation.
Like, no one knows this is what Abu Dhabi is, do you know what I mean?
Well, that's the point, right?
And like, yeah, they go to Yas,
okay,
and they go to Gallery, and they're like, oh, is that all there is in Abu Dhabi?
Well, okay, that's nice,
that
like a fancy shopping mall.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, people like my parents, they'd be way more interested to come here and see this.
Yeah,
than to go to Prada, where they can go anywhere in the world.
Yeah, exactly.
We made it to the sweets restaurant Al Aqsa, and as soon as I walked in, I was taken aback by how good it smelled. I'm actually not a big kanafa person, but I was very open to trying it, and the smells and the look of it got me thinking I'll probably be changing my mind about that. A big piece of kanafa is less than 12 dirhams or $3, and let me tell you, it's the best $3 you'll ever spend.
You are going to
forget it.
Wait yourself.
Yeah.
And then,
let's guess.
Ooh.
I'm just knocking.
Very out of.
That's so good.
Oh my god.
There you go.
Oh my god, that one. What is that? That's the nicest thing I've ever tasted. I'm not even joking.
That's a good cheese as well. Like that.
It's not my favorite.
Don't put you in a coma if you eat too much.
Really?
That's very sweet. Though.
Let me try it though.
Just one door down from Al Aqsa is Bona An restaurant, which is one of my favorite downtown restaurants. The Ethiopian food is to die for, and it's such a cute little restaurant.
That's what we're getting.
You sure?
This one. All the different meats and vegetables on an injera. It's so good.
So injera is basically a sour crepe or pancake, and have a very spongy-like texture. It's typically served with different types of stews and vegetables. As you can see here, there's so many different types of sides. My personal favorite are the meat stews, the beans, and the chickpeas. I also really love the cabbage. Though we did go for the meat option, I must mention this is also a great place for vegetarians and vegans. They have a lot of options for those of you which have those dietary requirements. In terms of price, this massive injera with all the different types of meats and vegetables is only 45 dirhams or $12. So at $6 a head, this is a real bargain. And obviously it goes without saying that the food is absolutely delicious.
No fork needed for this.
No fork provided.
Fork provided.
I've eaten here a few times, so I'm a huge fan already. As you can see, I was so happy. The food here really is top notch.
I've never seen popcorn with dessert. That is something new. They might want to be up all night. Probably. Is it a risk I'm willing to take? Probably. Oh, it's hot. That's really hot.
The coffee was absolutely worth it. Join me soon on the next episode of Hidden Gems as we venture even further into the culinary wonders of the capital. Also, let me know what your favorite Hidden Gem restaurants are in Abu Dhabi. Remember to like and subscribe for more awesome content like this.